So first of all, I would like to thank you, the chairs of this session, for letting us present our research. This is the overview of our presentation, and this is the research questions and the aims of our research. Everything started from the necessity to respond to archaeological questions regarding the study, analysis, interpretation, and I would say also reinterpretation of past excavations and their materials. So we started from these questions and how to resolve these questions. So our main research questions is how can, for example, a 3D digital approach help archaeologists to give new interpretations about past studies and support current ones? Or how can digital technologies help to solve issues related, for example, to published or unpublished documentation of archaeological excavations and their materials? So the main aim is, the research aims is digitally re-examine a past excavation in its material in order to get new information that could be useful to their interpretation of these cases. And we chose as a case study the Aierini site in Cyprus. So before entering in the project, I would like to give you some information about the context. This is the Swedish Cyprus expedition. It was an expedition that during the 30s arrived in Cyprus to establish the chronology of the island. So for doing that, started to excavate many sites in the island, and is considered that this expedition laid the foundation for the study of all aspects of Cypriot archaeology. There were four bold young archaeologists that excavated many sites. There was Einar Gjerstad that was the leader of the mission, and the other two archaeologists, and the third one was an architect. So during this time, they traveled in the island to excavate many places at the same time. So this is the result of their studies. So they excavated many sites, as you can see, and one of these is Aierini. So in 4 years, this is the results of their studies. And for what concern Aierini, they started to excavate in October 29, and in very few months, because at the end of the year, they finished to excavate the site. So this means that really in few time, they brought light this site. The site is in the north of Cyprus, and as you know, at the moment, since 1974, the north part of Cyprus is occupied by Turkish troops. So the site is inaccessible at the moment. So beyond having a past excavation that was done in a few months, we have also this other problem, this other issue, that the site is not accessible, so it's covered, we can't see anything, and of course it's not possible also to have further investigation on the site. The site was interpreted as a sanctuary. So this is the interpretation of the of the site, according to the archaeologists, had seven periods of use the sanctuary, and the starting point is in the late Cypriot III until the last quarter of the Cypro-Archaic second period. with a small until the Temenos was abandoned around 500 BC. So there is a long life for this sanctuary. And this is the collection. So in the Temenos, they found close to the altar around 2,000 statues and statues, as you can see from these pictures. These pictures are coming from the archive of the Swedish Cyprus expedition that are now conserved at the Medelhavsmuseet in Stockholm, because also the material, the finds were divided between Cyprus and Sweden, so at the moment are divided in different museums. And from these pictures we can see of course the discovery of the site, but also the setting of the of the finds. So investigating this this material, studying this material, we started to identify some issues in the publication of this data and so on. So the first thing is that the site has been published by the leader of the excavation, yes, that, but not by the archaeologist who excavated the site, Schockquist. So this also could have problems in the interpretation of the material. The results were published in 1935, so almost 6 years later the excavation, plus some revisions later on in 48 and 63. Another thing that was identified in the study of the material, they are the different opinions regarding the stratigraphy and the floods stratigraphy of the site, because it was considered that the site was abandoned and reused and reabandoned for the presence of floods that covered the site. So there is also this inconsistency in the interpretation between the archaeologists within the same expedition. So four or two. Then other inconsistencies are identified in the stratigraphic position of the figurines, and this is part also subject of my PhD study. And other inconsistencies are between the material published and the unpublished one. So for example, some drawings of the architect are different from the published ones. Some sections are wrongly published, so in reverse, and therefore probably not really well interpreted. And also not all original maps and sections that are conserved in the archives, there are not anymore the original maps and section. Then another problem is where is the sanctuary, the position, the exact position of the sanctuaries. Another one, some layers were not identified in all the parts of the sites. And another problem is the relative reference measurement systems that is not related to absolute values. So again, another problem. So what is the possible solution for this? So we thought to the digital reassessment of the Aerini stratigraphy through the use of published and unpublished material in order to see if these issues identified can be solved. So as I previously mentioned, the first problem was where is the exact position of the sanctuary. As you can see here, we have a map with the Temenos and the buildings of the Temenos. And then this other building that is a church that is still there. So we have a reference point. And this is what is used to georeference the map. And as you can see here, for example, the church on top of there, and the georeferencing, this is the position of the sanctuary. But we did also some tests, because, for example, while georeferencing and taking as a reference the church, there are some differences in the georeferencing of the other elements. So, for example, the streets are not in the same position. And then another test was done after the survey of the area. But as you can see, the structure of the buildings of the temenos changed completely. So the choice was for having the first test, and this is also supported by some pictures always in the archive. So we can see the position of the church, and we can identify these walls with the external walls of the temenos, and that's why the first solution. And here we have also other pictures where we can that we can use to identify some parts of the maps and of the sanctuary that were not considered in the publication. Here we have an example of the wrong interpretation and publication of the section. So as you can see, were published in reverse. So again, another problem that can be solved through the digital reassessment of the stratigraphy. Another problem, as I mentioned before, was the presence in the unpublished maps of parts of the temenos that were not published. So probably the archaeologists didn't consider these parts because they didn't understand. So through the unpublished maps, we can find also other elements. So the solution was the digital reassessment of the Aierini stratigraphy in a 3D GIS environment using both published and unpublished data. And I will show you what was the steps of this reconstruction. So first of all, the reconstruction of the levels. We have the eight points because in the text they were not published this information, but we have, for example, from the unpublished maps, and we have all the information about the points. But the problem is that these points, we don't know the absolute eights because we don't have the reference system that they used. So this is also another problem. The second step was the 3D reconstruction of the walls, because we have the information about the absolute eights of the walls. So the second step was the reconstruction of the walls. And then the reconstruction of the sections. As you can see, we have the levels that I said of the reference system of the Swedish mission. But of course, we had to reconstruct the absolute measurements, the measurements of the layers, in order to be integrated in the project. And finally, this is the reconstruction of the walls levels, assuming a fake plane. So we decided for a reference system. We construct a reference system that is connected with that one of the excavation. Yes. And then the last part is the integration of the finds and of the figurines. Also, this map, as you can see, is not a measured map. So also, this is a problem to identify the real position of the statuettes. But we have for this at least the levels of the finds, so this can be integrated in the reference system that we created. And for what concern the statuettes, we have the 3D of the statuettes that we can insert in the volumetric stratigraphy of the sanctuary in order to finally integrate the finds, the position, the levels, and the walls, and all the stratigraphy. And this is, for example, this is the last part about the reconstruction of the volumetric features in the 3D environment in order to integrate and check what are the errors and the solutions. Finally, so this is the conclusions. We identified some issues and we proposed some solutions regarding the inconsistency within the maps, the maps errors, and the lack of measurements. Of course, this was perfect study to recycle the published material and the analysis of the unpublished materials. And we have, in this way, a 3D holistic vision as a solution for the reinterpretation of the of a past and accessible excavation. Thank you.